Now we know complex numbers, we can solve every quadratic equation, even if the discriminant is negative. How? That is what you will learn in this video. We will start out with the easiest one, x squared plus 1 equals 0. So, I'm going to do that while you learn how to compute square roots. It's basically the form x squared equals minus 1. So we are basically computing the root of minus 1. So you know how to do it. First you write the minus 1 in polar form, then the x in polar form, and you solve. So write the minus 1 in polar form, is over pi plus a multiple of 2 pi I, with a norm equals to 1. And then you know how to solve this. You get two solutions, x0 equals e to the power times I times 1 half pi equals I, and x1, the other one for k equals 1, e to the power I times 3 pi over 2 equals minus I. So your solutions will be plus and minus I. And you can verify that easily, of course, by plugging them in the original equation. I squared plus 1 equals minus 1 plus 1 equals 0 is okay. Minus I squared plus 1 equals minus 1 squared equals 1 times I squared equals minus 1 plus 1 equals 0 is also okay. So now how to solve x squared plus 1 equals 0. So if you would do, for example, x squared plus 9 equals 0, well, you can see it straight away now. If you know x squared plus 1 equals 0, you know the solution of plus or minus I. And similarly, for x squared plus 9 equals 0, solutions will be plus or minus 3i. So you can do now quadratic equations as long as they don't have a linear term. But what if they have a linear term? Like if you want to solve x squared plus 2x plus 2 equals 0. Well, in that case, you can complete the square. The x squared plus 2x plus 2 equals x plus 1 squared. Well, if you have x plus 1 squared, you have x squared plus 2x plus 1. So we miss a factor of 1, so we have to add that equals 0. And then you can, for example, set wx equals x plus 1. That means that you would get w squared plus 1 equals 0. Now you know how to do that. W squared plus 1 equals 0. You just did that. That means w equals plus or minus I. And then you can find your x because x equals w minus 1. So x equals minus 1 plus w equals minus 1 plus or minus I. So also, if you have a linear factor in your quadratic equation, you can just solve it by completing the square. What happens if we would just try to use our ABC formula? What about the quadratic formula? What if we would just try that? We know from high school, if you have an equation of the form a times x squared plus b times x plus c, you can write the equation as follows. X equals minus b plus minus square root b squared minus 4ac over 2a. So what happens if we would apply that to our example? X squared plus 2x plus 2 equals 0. And a equals 1, b equals 2, c equals 2. So if we do just plug that in, we get a minus b minus 2 plus a minus square root b squared minus 4 times a times c. So that yields a 4 minus 8 equals the square root of minus 4 over 2. So simplifying it a bit, you get x equals minus 1 plus or minus 1 half times the square root of minus 4. Well, you can write minus 4 as minus 1 times 4. So square root of 4 times square root of minus 1, take the square root of 4 out, and you get the minus 1 plus or minus the square root of minus 1. And, well, the square root of minus 1 is the square root of, say, a complex number, has two solutions, plus or minus I. But in this formula, in this quadratic equations formula, this plus or minus is already incorporated in the formula itself. So here, you can replace the square root of minus 1 by I, and you get as your solutions minus 1 plus or minus I. So if you have a quadratic equation involving a linear term, you can either complete the square and find the solutions, or you can use the quadratic formula where you replace the square root of minus 1 by I. Well, of course, they're completely the same because this quadratic formula is derived from the completion of the square. So that's why you can use both. So let's summarize. We now have that every quadratic equation has two solutions. Later on we will see that every nth degree polynomial, so if you go on, we'll have n solutions, well, to prove the ladder. So this is a really nice theorem, though it's not constructive. It will not tell you how to find them. And in order to prove the ladder statement, we will have to understand what analytic functions are. So that will come later on. But for now, you can use the result that any nth order equation has exactly n solutions if you can use complex numbers.